Hey, what's up, guys? It's September and it's another month, so it's time for an update. And finally, I'm able to add the Mini S into the monthly update. So, like I said, I'm going to be doing an update for each tank. I'll be broken down by week so that since I have four tanks, you know, you'll get one a week. That way, like, the whole month will be covered and you'll have something to look forward to. So, for this tank, I started a little over a month ago, and it's looking great. Like, it's a low tech tank. Pretty much I just have lighting. I haven't started fertilizing yet. The only thing I've been doing is adding Excel daily, and as you can see, the HC is growing very nice. Actually, this is like probably one of the best HC growth that I've gotten, like, ever. Before, I've been trying to grow it in the 60p and I have had success, but most of the time algae would take over eventually, and I had CO2 running there as well, and it grew just fine, but it was just the algae that I had issues with. And right now, since this is a newer tank, I think the algae will probably come in the future, but hopefully I'll have it under control with some of these algae eaters. I have three autos, as you can see, two to the left there, and one to the far right low corner there. And I have a bunch of shrimp. So the shrimp, they do like algae too, and hopefully they'll keep it under bay. The one thing that I should have done initially, and I highly recommend this, is to let the HC root before you add any like livestock. I was kind of, I guess, rushing it a little bit, but I think it still turned out fine. But as you can see here, there's a lot of gaps in between here, and it was because the HC couldn't fully root yet. And then when I added the nerite snails and the snails, they would love to like kind of like go along the wall and then go under here and in between here, and it would just kind of uproot this. And there's no way for me to like really push this down other than like digging a hole, putting it down, and then putting like soil on top. And it's more of a hassle. So now I'm just letting the roots grow long and grab from there down to the bottom. So I'm really happy with the HC growth here, and actually it's looking really nice. And actually some of it, like for example, this side looks like it needs a trim, and maybe like the bush over here already needs trimming. And so it looks good. And actually, if you look in the back here, the japonicas, when I added them in, I only added three, I believe, or four, I forget. They've already made like replicas, or I guess runners out, you know, runners. And it's already filled in the back really nicely. The only corner that isn't filled in is just this corner here. It's actually gotten really bushy already. And it melted back when I added it in there, because it went from a basically like a CO2 heavy, you know, high light condition into like a low tech. It had hot, you know, this one has decent, really good lighting. It's just, there's no CO2. It's just from Excel is really getting all the CO2 and really no fertilizer yet. And right now, everything's running great in this tank so far, and hopefully it'll continue that way. I'm still trying, you know, I'm growing, I guess, I don't know, I think this is Java moss or Christmas moss, whatever. And, you know, these three are doing pretty good. Notice a couple of these moss balls started to kind of die off, so I might have to toss some of those, but I might replace that one with one big one. Like one big, you know, ball, but we'll see. It seems like the shrimp really like this, whatever this is. I think it's fissures or something like that. It's some sort of version of moss, but they really like that one more than actually the Java. In terms of livestock, the fish is the same four rose boras. I didn't add anything new other than the shrimp. As I mentioned, they were coming in the mail. Let me see if I can try to find some. No. Okay, I can't really find any. But anyways, I added, I don't see anything. But I added basically some, I guess, harder species to keep. Some blue bolts. I think I had like four or five of them in here. I had some King Kongs. I think I had like three or four. And on order, I'm getting some more Bloody Marys. I have one back there. I think I got under there. Blue Diamonds on here as well. And then I think those are it. And then just some crystal red shrimps here and there. I think they are the SS type pattern. And that's it, I think. Oh, and then some orange eye blue tigers. And that's it. I didn't get like very much. I kind of got like a Skittle. Like I said, it's a mixture of just shrimps. And really, it's just experimenting the conditions, the shrimps, just to see what works, what doesn't work. And surprisingly, I think the higher grade shrimps are working a lot better than the lower grade shrimps for some reason. The routine in this tank so far has been a 50% water change weekly. I've been kind of keeping that up just because I don't want the algae to break out, and I want, you know, the plants to look nice. And pretty much on top there, I have some red-rooted floaters, and hopefully that will continue to grow really nicely. And then, you know, I can sell them off, but there's some duckweed on here too I'll probably have to end up getting rid of. But yeah, everything is pretty solid, pretty consistent, and hopefully it continues this way, and hopefully the shrimp population will double, triple, whatever, and get some maybe new species from this somehow. That'd be awesome, actually. But yeah, everything's looking really nice, and for everyone or anyone who says, hey, you can grow HC, you know, without CO2, well, you can grow them with just XL. I mean, it's a form of CO2, but you don't need pressurized CO2. And also, look at it. I mean, it looks great. So, yeah. And stay tuned, guys, for more. Peace.